Okay, good morning. This week, Parasha, we start Parashat Shemini. Parashat Shemini is Parasha right after Pesach, usually. Again, Vahi Bayom HaShemini, Gara Moshe Aharonah, with the Bnei Israel. And it was on the eighth day, Gara Moshe, Moshe called Aharon, and his children, and all of the elders of Israel. In other words, we have 7 days of Miluim. We learned last week Parasha, that Akadosh Baruch Hu told Moshe, the 7 days of the Miluim, You're gonna be doing the avodah. Moshe Rabbeinu served as a kohen. 7 days he brought the korbanot and everything. And now that was the training time. Yemei miluim that we learned last, in other words, at the end of Parashat Tzav, and that was at the time of inauguration of the kohanim for 7 days. Now we're gonna be having the Yom Shemini, which is Rosh Chodesh of Nisan, according to Rashi. Those 7 days was before Rosh Chodesh Nisan. Rashi says Shemini Lemiluim. That was Shemini Lemiluim. Who Rosh Chodesh Nisan? Shuga Mishkan. Bo Biyom. That was the day that the Mishkan was established. Not that Eser Atarot and Shnor Beseder Olam. And that day got 10 crowns. In other words, 10 crowns was given that day to Kahal Israel. Was first ground was first was Masir by Sebreshit at the Rosh Chodesh, and the first that was the first Chodesh, Achilat Kochim. In other words, Achilat Kochim was done Bishon the Banod Nesim, Bishon the Kehuna, the Abuda, the Yiridat Ha'esh, Achilat Kochim, the Makom Chodesh, Lishkon Shekhina, and Birkat Vanim, and Isur Habamot. There were 10 crowns that the Harisol got on this day, on Rosh Chodesh Nisan, and that was the day that the Mishkan was established. Yom El Aharon Kahlecha Egil Mavagal Lechatot Vayilola Termim Parlef Hashem. And Yom El Aharon told Aharon, and Hakadosh Baruch Hu told Moshe Aharon Vanav, that was Alpid Tipur Hakadosh Baruch Hu. Hashem told Moshe tell Aharon, Kahlecha, you should take for yourself. What is it for yourself? Kahlecha, Egel Baga bin Baga lechatot, Egel Kaf bin Baga for Khatot, the Ayil Ola, and Ayil for burnt offering, Temim should be unblemished, Barlef Hashem, and you should bring it close in front of Hashem. Therefore, that was for Aharon. Now, Rashi Zechne Israel, Lehashmiyam, Shalpiatipur, Aharon Sar, not Mishosh Bekiona Gedura. ולו יאמרו מעליו נכנעת. He gathered all of the elders of Israel to tell them that, you know, they should know that Hashem is selecting Aharon. It wasn't something that he did himself. Therefore, he had to bring Kahlecha Egel, להודיע שנכף ירבו לאחר כולו על ידי Egel זה, מה יעשה Egel, שעשה. Therefore, the Egel is to show him that Akadosh Baruch Hu is מכפר, מה יעשה Egel, because if we want to bring the Shekhinah, we need to rectify Egel. Therefore, Hashem is forgiving the mice of Egel that Aharon did. And Ayilola, always when we bring the atonement, we bring a gift. Gift is the Ola. That was the Korban of Aharon. Aharon, the rule in Torah is, at first you have to correct yourself, then you correct other people. First you mekaper yourself. Once you get kapara yourself, then you can mekaper other people. Now you tell about Aristotle, the Aristotle, that's the Korban of Aristotle. They should bring, say, a male of a goat, lechatot, for sin offering, the egel and the calf, vakeves, and the sheep, benishana, 1 year old, temimim, complete, and blemished, le'ula, korban ula. The short while, and the bull, a cow, the eye, the ram, the shlamim, korban shlamim, the swova, to sladden, in front of Hashem, and the meal offering mixed with oil, because the Hayom, Hashem would be revealed to you. Therefore, that is the Korban of Kahal Yisrael. Now, why do you need all of this Korban for Kahal Yisrael? First, you have Seir Isim. Now, the Midrash says, what does Seir Isim come from? Come for? Seir Isim comes to be Mechaber, the head of the brothers that they sold Yosef. And what they do? They took the blood of Seir goat and put it on the Ketoret Pasim. They were Seir Izim, another word. No, we want to have Shekhinah. We can't have Shekhinah without atonement for all the sins that they made. All of these things has to be rectified. Then we could have Shekhinah. First is the Mechirat Yosef, as we said, the Haggad also. We start Tibul. The first Tibul is Mechirat Yosef to tell us that we are still in Galut because of the jealousy and sin of between Qahar Israel. They will say it is in for Mechirat Yosef. The Egel, Egel is clear. Egel is to be Mechaper on the Chet of Egel for Qahar Israel. The Keves Ben Shana, Temimim Leola. Balaturim says Egel, the Keves. Keves comes from Kevesh, Lichbosh, to capture my Seha Egel. They were Egel and Keves Beneshana, now the word that's Balaturim says. The Midrash says we need Keves to bring the memory of Agadat Yitzchak, the Agadat Yitzchak, she kafted Keves because he was tied up like a sheep to be sacrificed for Akadosh Baruch Hu. That Zechud and Merit we need. We sure why. Then we need sure. We ayin leshlamim. The subach lifnei Hashem mincha b'la b'shamim. Now, the word we did say is zin by doing it is zin. We get egel because of the egel. Keves Zechud and Mitzchah. Then we sure why. Why do we need sure why? Why do we need ayin? Ayin Baal HaTorim says unbelievable point. If you have a Baal HaTorim, you pay attention to Baal HaTorim. Baal HaTorim says why bring ayin? Shihaya miraket lifnei ki ayon. Why do you think he will not do Qahar Israel? They have to bring Ay, they have to bring a ram. Now the question is why? Why do you have to bring a ram? What's the ram for? Balaturim says, Shaya Mirak and Diflem Bikay. In other words, when they made the Egel, what did Egel do for them? What was the mood? What was the mood of the Egel? With what type of mood they saw Egel? Egel was dancing. Shaya Mirak and Diflem Kay. He was dancing like a ram. Like the pastor says in Mizmor David, we say every day, in Mizmor David, that we say, today we say with Hashem before Shabbat, they made them dance like Egel. Now, it's very interesting, show you miracle flame, Kaya, in other words. Why do we bring ram? Because ram comes to make atonement, something about Egel. What needs atonement? We bring the egel for the egel. We brought the egel. Why do we need ayin? We need ayin. Veregedem kama egel. Veregedem shoyam meraged iflem ki ayol. Because the egel was dancing like ayol. Ayol is famous for dancing. In Halil also we say, Harim, they say, Yevaot ki ayol, that they get the mountains and the hills, they dance like the ayol. Because ayol, in other words, Ayol, the movement of the ayol is a very special movement. It's like dancing. In other words, in the animals, the one would be presenting dancing is ayol. Therefore, egel was dancing like ayol was a dancer. Therefore, for that dancing of egel, we need a special kapara. Kapara of the egel is because of the sin of egel. Ayol is because of the desire, because of the love, because of the enjoyment that they showed in the sin. In other words, when a person does the sin, it's not just the point of the sin itself. It's a matter of the quality and the involvement, how much enjoyment, how much person is sad is doing a sin, person is happy, is full of enjoyment, person is nebach, I have to do, right? Therefore, everything for HaKadosh Baruch Hu, each level has its own as his own thing in front of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. It's not the same. Therefore, here, I, because of the dancing of the I, they have to bring a ram to make atonement of the enjoyment. Now, it's very interesting that on Kabbalat Shabbat, Kabbalat Shabbat, to denote that enjoyment that they had for the Egel, now with the enjoyment that we have to recover Shabbat to rectify what they did for the Egel. That's why in the Mizmor David, before Shabbat, he mentioned Egel to point out to ourselves the joy and the pleasure that they had for the Egel of dancing. Now with the joy and pleasure of the mitzvah, we should be mechaper on the Egel. They were re-explained so far. Why do you say this in Mechlat Yosef? Egel for the Chet of Egel, Keves comes for Agadat Yitzchak, Ay comes for Ayin comes for dancing, for the enjoyment. No, we have to explain shor. Why do we need to bring shor? Why do we have to bring shor? Now, it's very interesting, Sifri. In other words, the Midrash on Vayikra, the Midrash says an unbelievable point. In other words, it was a very big chiddush to me. The Midrash points out that why do we have to bring Eger and Shor? Why do we need two things to be brought here for the Korban? In other words, we bring Eger. Eger is for Chetav Eger. Why do we need to bring Eger and Shor? Now, the Midrash says, Shor v'ayil shramim, we need Shor v'ayil shramim, lefi shnei mit avira l'shnei minim. Because the avira was two types, the Chetav Eger was two types, shnei mat, asur ayim gel amesecha. In the parasha, Torah says, they made for them Eger, a calf of mountain, masecha, ul halon omer, but in the Tehillim, when David HaMelech explains the Chetav Egel in Tehillim, he says, Vayomiru et kevodam betavnit shor, ocher eser. They exchange their kevodam, the honor, with the tablet, the image of cow that eats eser, it's grass. Now Rashi explains what's the point of shor ocher eser, because shor eats grass, and then the excrete of grass would make him more mouse, becomes more disgusting. And that was what they did. They had the exchange, the honor that they had with the shor. Now, Yabu shor v'chaper al ma'aseh shor. Yabu egel v'chaper al ma'aseh egel. There are two korbanot, two different aspects of egel. Egel would come and is mechaper make atonement on the egel that they made. V'aseh ma'asecha. And the shor should come to be mechaper al ma'aseh shor. What did they do to the shor? V'yamiru et kevodam, v'yamiru because immediately they exchange their honor with tablet shor with the image of shor ocher eser. Now Malbim here explains what does it mean there are two aspects in the head. In other words, what they did was like this. They made the egg. In other words, really what they did like this. There are four images in Kisah HaKavod. One image of Adam, one image of eagle. Now Adam is the highest form of the Bria. With the understanding, with the reading to Shwarku, and that's the purpose of the video. Then we have the image of the eagle, the king of the bird. Then we have the shore, the kingdom of the domestic animal. And then we have the lion, the king of the wild animal. These are four aspects of the Kisah HaKavod. Each one of them kingdom, and Adam is above all. Rabbi Baruch Hu is saying that all of this kochot has to be used for Adam to capture the Malchut of Hashem. We need the ambition and flying of the eagle to fly and come to Rabbi Baruch Hu. We need the power and the kovach of the Aryeh, braveness of Aryeh to fight the Milchavot of Hashem. We need the kovach of the shor plowing to prepare and to do things that we have to do. All of these three kochot are being given to Adam to bring out the Kisah HaKavod. Now that is, but the Adam, what Adam presents, what Adam stands for, Adam stands for the image of Adam. And that was image that the Har Yisrael should represent themselves. But somehow, the Har Yisrael in the Midbar, they felt that they don't want to relate the HaKadosh Baruch Hu with the Adam. They wanted Shor Ocher Eser. They wanted to change the image. That's why David HaMelech is saying, he says, in other words, Hazal tell us that the Har Yisrael, they didn't do the sin of Egel, and it's to be matter for them, the Aroy, to be matter for themselves, the Aroy, to adultery and this type of things. What's Pshat? They wanted to do them? No. See, the point is like this. A lot of times, the person has a darga, has a level of Abu Dhabi HaKadosh Baruch Hu. It sort of comes to him and says, no, you are deprived, you have deprivation, you don't enjoy yourself. In other words, the life, there's so much enjoyment, so much pleasure, and you're not taking, you know, take it easy, you know. In other words, you have that image of Adam and Kisah HaKavod relate to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to enjoy Hashem, to be with HaKadosh Baruch Hu, but there is a word there. the word of tumah, the word of attraction, the word of cow, image of a cow, that ocher esev, pleasure, and hana uramaze. And the person would exchange that image of Adam to image of cow. They didn't want to be spiritual so much. They wanted to be Yashmiut. They say that we remember what we ate in Mitzrayim. What they ate in Mitzrayim? What is good? Here is man. Man is the food of Ruhani. One makes the person to be spiritual. But they wanted to go after taiva, after desire. And that was the way that Yisrael deceived them. And they exchanged that image of Elion. They damaged that image of Adam that belongs to a person. And they exchanged it to Shur. Therefore, we need two kaparot for Chetav Eger. One kapara, in other words, the image was Shur, but they didn't want the global Shur. They made the Eger to carry them. Because like just like Ramban explained, for the midbar, for the desert, we need Shur. We need the kubach of the Shur to prepare and to do that. Just like Shur plowing, prepares the food, prepares everything that kubach we need. Therefore, they said that this kubach we need, we should survive, but we don't want to be that high level of Adam to relate to HaKadosh Baruch Hu in such a high level of spirituality. They would exchange their honor, their kavod, the image from Adam to Shur Ocher Esev. Therefore, they did two things. One thing, they got Shur, which was global. They were the Egel, tangible Egel to worship. And then they might damage the Elyonim. Therefore, here they have to bring two korbanot to be mechaper. One, they should bring the korban of Egel for the Egel that they made, and they brought Shur for the chet of image of Elyon. What we learn from it? We learn from it if they tell you what's the chet of Egel. Chet of Egel is the lowering of dark. The person could belong or belongs to higher rank of Avodat Hashem, and he lowers down himself to come down. He says, oh, they're so from, they're fanatic. I'm okay, I'm fine. That is not the way. Always the person, the way that person should feel like this. Person should feel, I'm long away to be a true Ovid Hashem in any term. In terms of learning, in terms of honesty, in terms of integrity. If a person feels, I did the job, I'm honest enough. Most people are not like me, I'm much better than them, I'm enough. If a person says, Dayenu, Dayenu is enough for us, you have to hit him. You know, Dayenu, you have to hit. Because you, Dayenu is a danger zone. Once you feel, I'm not enough, you know, Baruch Hashem, I worked on Anubut. I worked on my anger. I worked on my gaiva. If a person feels like that, that's Egel. Egel means that you feel that you did it. And you know, it's enough. I don't want. In other words, the way to Avodah HaKadosh Baruch Hu is, always we have to think it's the long way to go. The long way to, I should fix up my tefillah. It's the long way to go to fix up my davening, my Torah learning. It's the long way I have to be more honest in my business. The long way to go that I should be more humble. It's the more longer way to go I shouldn't get angry. The long way to go that I have to treat my children, my wife, my family better, my friends better, better recognition, better understanding, better relating. Once you feel there is a long way to go and to get it, then you are on the right zone, you are on the right road. But once, as soon as the person feels that I did it, I have it, right? That's Shur Ocher Esev. Beautiful. Now, Mr. Pashuk, hey, they took by the Moshe, says, they put in front of the Ohel Moed, I brought all of the assembly and stood in front of Hashem, and you made Moshe, say, I don't to Hashem. This is the one that Hashem said, by Yero Alechem, you would Hashem, and Hashem would appear from you. Therefore, that was a dream for Kahal Israel to have the Shekhinah come to them. And a lot of times, we feel Shekhinah should come to us, you have to climb mountains, you have to go, say, I don't want, that you should do. Hashem doesn't want. Hashem doesn't burden us. Hashem doesn't tell us, you know, we have to do this. No, two korban, by Yomer Asher Aharon. Moshe told Aharon, you should come close to the Mizbeach, and should do your Chatot, Gulatecha, V'chaper Ba'atcha, and you should provide atonement for yourself and for the nation, and you should do the korban of the nation, V'chaper Ba'atcha, and should provide atonement for them. Kasher Tiba Hashem, that's what Hashem says. Now, why did Moshe Rabbeinu have to tell Aharon, Rashi, Because Aharon was embarrassed. He would feel that I'm not deserving. I don't deserve this. It's above me. There are much better people than me. That's another yesod in life. Yesod in life is, what does Hashem want from us? If a person feels, I deserve it, you don't deserve it. In this world, we don't deserve anything. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is telling Moshe, Moshe says, Aharon, Hashem chose you, you come. Now I say, oh, Baruch Hashem, I'm such a nice person, such a talented. At the end of the day, I'm a brother of Moshe. I'm even an older brother. I'm the son of Amram. I deserve, I'm the best candidate for this. Once the person feels like that, it's Yetzirah. Then the person, Akash Baruch Hu, says, I can't live with you under one roof. All of life is a person should feel, I don't deserve. Then I will have a Shmiah. Moshe Rabbeinu asked to push Aharon to go for something. If somebody feels, I deserve it, I'm the one, this is the wrong person. If a person feels is unworthy, it doesn't deserve, then deserve. Aharon came to Mizbeach and shech the egel achatot. Egel achatot for himself. First, you correct yourself, you make atonement for yourself. And Vayakhlu b'nei Aharon et Adam, and the children of Aharon, they brought the dam to him. Vayitpol betzvao, and he dipped his finger in the dam. Vayitein achanot ha-mizbeach, and put on the horns of the mizbeach. Bet Adam yotzach, and the dam and the remaining of the blood poured it on Yesod HaMitzvah, on the foundation of the Mizbeach. V'tachele, v'fat, v'pi, v'takilav, kidneys, atoret diaphragm, min akavet, from the liver, from Chatot, v'it HaMizbeach, and caused go up to smoke on the Mizbeach, just as Hashem told Moshe. V'it HaBasar, and the Basar, the Taor, and the Hai, so that we burned in fire, v'chut HaMachan, outside the camp, v'ishchal Ta'ola, v'imtzeu ben Aharon, and shech Ta'ola, and Vayamtsu ben Aharon Elav et Adam, and they pressed the sons of Aharon to him, the dam, the blood, Vayizretehu al Mizbeach, and he threw it on the Mizbeach, Savir, Vayit Ha'ola himtsu Elav, and the Ola they brought it to him, Nitachen to pieces, the Rosh, the head, Vayachter al Mizbeach, and he smoked it, caused it to go up in the smoke on the Mizbeach, and he washed the Kerev Ha'Kraim, the inners and the crime and defeat, because always in the Korbanot you wash them, because they are dirty. First, he brought his korban. Therefore, the korban that he brings, in other words, it's very interesting that Aharon brings egel b'bagar lechatot. Aharon brings egel lechatot v'ayil le'ola. Gal Yisrael, they bring seirisim lechatot egel le'ola. In other words, Aharon brings the chet of egel for him is chatot. The Har Yisrael, Egel for them is Ola. Now, Rashi say, why is it like that? It's very interesting. Both are atonement for Chetav Egel. Aharon brings Korban, the Har Yisrael, they bring Korban. Both bring Egel. Aharon's Egel goes for Chatot, Korban Chatot, and the Egel of the Har Yisrael is Ola. Why is it like that? Come tell us, there's a difference between Chatot and Ola. Chatot is the for a sin that the person does, even though that is shogeg, but the mice said it. They said that he did Chilul Shabbat, he didn't remember today's Shabbat, he did Shabbat. Even though that the intention was not there, but for the wrong mice, he has to bring korban. All a person brings because of the wrong machshav. Even though that, in other words, the person has a hirhurim, he brings the ola. Ola is for machshav, even though that there's no mice. No. By Aharon, the chet that he did was with the maaseh. He didn't have intention for the sin. Why? Because he said that I'm going to make the egel, Moshe Rabbeinu would come. He didn't have intention, chasunum, that for the egel should be egel. He just said, they were the maaseh that he did was wrong. They would have to bring chatot. But when chatot, egel of Aharon is chatot because the maaseh did the chet. Now, what about the Har Yisrael? The Har Yisrael, really, their intention, the mice, they didn't make the egg. But the intention that they had was, since Moshe Rabbeinu is not here, we need to substitute Moshe Rabbeinu. But the real chet of the Har Yisrael were in their mentality. Because they thought that since Moshe Rabbeinu is not here, we have to convey to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, in other words, through something else. And that was their chid. Therefore, the Ergel for them is the Ergel for them is Ola, because Ola is a sin that the person does by the Machshava. Now, every korban that we bring, the blood is represents the soul of person, would be sprinkled on the Mizbeach, and then the fat and the inner part and the liver, all of these things are kidneys. Fat means we have in Torah Chelev and Shuman. Shuman is something, the muscles, that's the charbi or fat. Chelev in Hebrew, in English, we don't have a word for it, but Chelev is with pea. It's not fat. There's a difference between pea and charbi, fat. Charbi is something that is the muscles, helps the muscle to grow. Chelev is something that piles up on the body. Now, the piling up creates laziness, this type of desire in a person. That was brought on the korban, on Mizbeah. Then kidneys. Chazal tells kidneys gives advice to a person. What does kidney do to a person? Kidney purifies the blood. Purification is the way of giving advice. Person is confused. They don't know what to do. What would you? You purify for him. This is good. This is bad. This should be done. This should not be done. There were kaloyot kidneys, or therefore somebody who sins, the kidneys didn't do a good job for him. Liver is the place that makes the blood. That's the most materialistic part of the body. Therefore, all of that has to be smoked in front of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and they took it out. All of the, no, they took it out and they burned it. That is symbolic of all of the things of the head has to be taken away. The Gemara says that if somebody is a gambler and he wants to do teshuva, what's the process of his teshuva? He has to destroy the dice. As long as he keeps the dice in the closet someplace, it's not a good teshuva. Teshuva, you have to disconnect yourself totally from the sin. As long as there is a resemblance of the sin somehow in you, that you could connect to the sin through that's why somebody came to Rambam and told Rambam that I was involved in adultery. I don't can't do teshuva on that. I did, you know, had wrong desires and did activities that should not be done, like a modesty, and I cannot do teshuva. He said, how do I do to the teshuva? He says that I think about them and I try to see what could I do to fix up myself. Rambam says, that's your problem. In other words, the way to do teshuva on this type of sin is to disconnect yourself from the sin totally. A lot of times, the Tzerhara tells a person to think about it, because when you think about it, you are regenerating the sin in yourself. And that is worse. That makes the motivation for the sin again. Whereas in Masiyach Da'atomimena, Rambam says. Rambam says the best way is to Masiyach Da'atomimena, to cut it off. No, I learn Gemara. I think about something else. You have something, think about your business. Think about something that, you know, makes you busy thinking. That you should not be thinking about, you shouldn't be thinking about that. Masiyach Da'atomimena. Here also Torah says, you have to burn it completely. Through that would be atonement. The atonement is through burning that completely. Now, once he brought this korban and he's mechaper on himself, now it goes to the sibul. First you straighten yourself and then the sibul. And he brought the korban home and he took seir chatot, asher ram seir adam, he said seir for michlat Yosef, and shechtit, by chateu, he performed the sin offering service on it, karishon, as for the first one, by yagre betaura, and by yagre betaura, according to judgment, according to law. By yagre betaminchai, he brought the meal offering, and he filled his palm from it, and it's called the smoyin mesbeach, aside from the olat ha-boker, and Sheikh the Shur Bahayin, Zebach Shlamin, Zebach of Peace Offering, Ashram, I am two when Aaron the Dom, I am two and depressed the children of Aaron the blood to him, by his letehu and Mizbeach, and threw it on Mizbeach of Aaron, and the fat from the cow, and from the ayin, from the ram, Al Yod, the tail that covers the kidneys, where you tell it, and die from with the liver, Abayasim, and they put the fat alachazot on the chest and cause smoke and miach. And the chest and the right thigh, Aaron lift up his hands, Aaron is belongs to the nation, and that was the first Birkat Kohanim. We said that 10 crowns, one of them was Birkat Kohanim. That was Birkat Kohanim, that and went down from that during the Khatat, and they come and they bench down by Iraq with Hashem Kohan. What does it mean? Process that they came and then Moshe by Moshe by Aharon. Process by Yisrael Aharon, they came and then they came. Rashi says, Vayavu Moshe by Aharon, Vayavu Moshe by Aharon, Lama Nichesu, Masati Prashad Miroi, Lama Nichlas Moshe by Aharon. Why did Moshe come with Aharon? Lamedu al Maisak the Torah. Oh, the Midrash says, once Aaron saw that everything was brought and the Shekhinah didn't come, he was annoyed, he was bothered, he had suffered, he had pain. Now, what do you think? Aaron comes and does everything and the Shekhinah is there. Whose fault is that? In our life, what do? Something goes wrong. Something doesn't work properly. It's not my fault. I'm okay. I did whatever that I could. I'm Aharon HaKohen. Now listen to him. Moshe Achi, Kach Asitari, Shinasti Bevashti. In other words, he says that if the Shekhinah is not coming, it's because of me. I did something wrong. See, that's the difference between Aharon and us. Very interesting. Aharon doesn't become Aharon just like that. We, something goes wrong, I'm fine, I'm perfect. Who is wrong? The people are wrong. He is wrong. It's my wife's fault, my children's fault, my rabbi's fault, somebody else. Person finds somebody like the other word that the Emra says, we are all children of Adam Arishon. Aharon told Adam Arishon, why did you eat from the tree? He says, Chava gave to me. He blames somebody else. We don't want to admit. We don't want. The Midrash says if Adam Arishon would admit that I did it, I'm sorry, I do teshuva, I would have been forgiven. Therefore, here, Aharon said, if there is something wrong, it's because of Miyad Nichnas Moshe and Meresh Rachamim, where the Shekhin of Israel. Miyad, right away, Moshe came and they dove in. Now, Taka, why did Shekhinah come? They did everything. Why didn't Shekhinah come? The Midrash says, do you know why didn't Shekhinah come? Because he didn't daven and pray for Shekhinah to come. It's an interesting life. Whatever that we do, we might do everything from A to Z, but still we need to daven. We need to pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. If we don't daven and pray, it doesn't happen. Unbelievable point. They did everything A to Z. All of the korbanot, everything Shekhinah come, didn't come. Because Rachamim Yad Shekhinah is there. We see the importance of Davin. And the fire came from Mifnei Hashem from Davin HaKadosh Baruch Hu, therefore the special fire from Kisei HaKavod, Vatochal and consumed on the Mizbeach, it Ha'olah, Korban Olah, Vechafat, and Vayar Yachulam, and all of the people, they saw that by Yoronu, and they sang in praise, Vayipelu, Vayipelu Al Penehem, and they fall upon their faces, in other words, the joy and happiness and reverence of Ramah HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Vayichu Ben Yaharon, and the children of Aaron, Nadab Abihu, each machdato, they took each one, each fire pan, and they put on it ash, fire, by Yisim Allah, the third, and put the toilet, by Yisim Allah, the Hashem, and put the Hashem, ash, Zara. The fire was a lion, fire, foreign fire. Hashem, not Yisim Allah, Hashem didn't command them, but they said, Yisim Allah, and came out fire from Hashem, the same fire, Milifnei Hashem, Milifnei Hashem, but took all of them and consumed them. By Yomutu, and they died, Milifnei Hashem, by Yomer Moshe Aharon. That was Hashem said, with my close people, I will be sanctified, and in front of all of the nation, I will be honored. Aharon kept quiet. What happened here? Trust the Vayichu Ben Aharon, Nadab Abihu. In other words, Nadab Abihu they took. He says, Ben Aharon, Nadab Abihu. We know Nadab Abihu or Ben Aharon. They doesn't have to tell us. He says, Ben Aharon, Nadab Abihu. Torah, David, that Torah is very interesting. He says, Bene Aharon Nadav Aviv. That's a Nadav Aviv Bene Aharon. What does it mean, Bene Aharon Nadav Aviv? They really were the children of Aharon. But in this mindset, they acted like Nadav Aviv, as if they are not Bene Aharon. How come? What does it mean, as if they are not the children of Aharon? They didn't ask advice from the father. They wanted to do something, come to the father and ask him, Abba, is it the right thing to do or not? Sometimes the arrogancy, sometimes the person doesn't want to go to somebody else. In the creation of the world, HaKadosh Baruch Hu came and got advice from Malachim. Rashi says over there, why should Hashem do that? Because that's the fabric of creation. The fabric of creation of HaKadosh Baruch Hu is that a person should consult with other people. If a person feels that I'm the one, I know better than everybody else, that Arushi Vatalas. Anything that you feel you are the best, you know the best, you are wrong. You should know that there's something wrong with you. In other words, always consult HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that's the need. He consulted to teach us that the way that works with consulting. Here, Bene Aharon, your children of Aharon, but they acted like not above you. No, what they do, ish machdot vaitinu vayin ish, they put fire vaitinu vayin ish, ketoret vaitinu vayin ish, ish zara. What does ish zara means? Foreign fire. The Zohar HaKadosh says, really these children, they were full of fire of love to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. They wanted to show and express their love to Hashem. It's interesting. One would think, this parasha is not relevant to our days of life. Since 20th century that we are living, 2020. What is it? What is in Nokia to know what happened with Bnei Aharon 3,000 years ago? How does that help my life to know that? One of the most relevant parashot in Torah is this parashot, especially for nowadays. All of the parashot of Torah are relevant all the time, especially in this parashot. Because we are living in the world that people look for spirituality. People want to achieve spirituality. Even the Goyim, they want to achieve spirituality because they understand the emptiness of materialistic life. You go and indulge, you get nothing. You become more empty and empty and empty. It's like a Kelly's vessel. You want to fill it up. The more you fill it up, the more empty it gets. That's Chazal tell us. A person has this small limb that this to make him to satisfy, he's always hungry. You keep him hungry, he's satisfied. Therefore, they understand we need the spirituality. Now, the world understands the spirituality the way that they want to, the way that they feel like. Here, children of Aharon, they wanted to show their love. Fire is the love. And they wanted to show that fire and love. What did they do? They, upon whatever they decided, they imposed the love that they have to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. They chose the way that they want to show their love. And that's not the way that you show your love. You love somebody, you don't choose the way that you want to express your love and impose on the other person. That is not love. That is being selfish and self-centered. Torah is teaching us, a person wants to show love. Yes, you are full of love. How do you show it? You do things to please the other person. You listen to the other person. You do it in a way that the other person likes. That's a true love. But somebody who loves himself, he doesn't love the other person. He just loves himself to see himself in that state, in that mood, that thing that he wants to do. Then he imposes his love to the other person. And Chazal tell us that's not a love, that's a foreign. And from here, we learn a very big yesod in life. You want to express your love to your wife, you want to show your love to your children, you want to show your love to people, to your friends, you don't impose your love. You want to show love to your wife, the greatest love is listening and doing what pleases her. Not to impose on her the way that you plan is. You want to show love to your children. How should we show? You have to listen to them. You have to submit yourself. I give you a very good example. somebody wants to spend on one Sunday with his children or with his wife, and he wants to make a connection, you know, spend time, quality time. What does he do? He decides what does he wants to do with his friend, and he tells his friend, let's go to a party, we play together, and families together, and children together. And he imposes what he wants to do to the wife and children, and he goes to park. And park spends most of the time with his friend, and he deals with them, and he doesn't make any connection with his wife, not with children, nothing. And sometimes the wife and children don't like that thing because he imposed on them, and all of the Sunday they spend, and after the day they come frustrated on the father and the wife on the husband, why did you take us such place? See, that's not love. That's imposing. The way to show love is not imposing. Person has to understand what pleases them, what do you want to do, what do you want. Child, what do you want to, wife, what do you want to do? And you do what you, that they like. That is a true love. That was the ishtara that they brought. Now, the midrash test, and there's another midrash also, interesting midrash. Midrash says, really, Bnei Aharon, another very relevant point is like this. Bnei Aharon, they thought, Moshe Aharon, they got old. They don't know how to deal with this new generation. The new generation needs a new treatment. These people are too old. They say, Matai Yamutu Zekinim Halalu. When does it come that they're going to die and we take over? We know how to do it better than them. We have more wisdom to have to treat the new generation. These people are too old for this new generation. HaKadosh Baruch Hu says, do you think like that? Do you think that you're going to do a better job? Therefore, they died before them. That's another point in the Midrash that what happened in this. But anyway, Vayomer Moshe l'Aharon, Vayashet Dibar Hashem, Moshe told Aharon, Bichrubai Chodesh, with my close people, I would be sanctified. In other words, the Kiryakar says, if a Kodesh Baruch Hu destroys a Rasha, everybody says, Rasha died because it was a Rasha, and nobody would take a lesson. What does Hashem do? Hashem takes somebody who's Kodesh, somebody who's sacred, and through that, through his death, HaKadosh Baruch Hu becomes sanctified. Why? Because through his death, people would say, you know, see, such a great person, such a tzaddik died. And what's going to happen to us? Everybody would think, would make a cheshbon for himself. And once Aharon was crying, once Moshe told him that, you know, Moshe, the Midrash says here, Moshe says that I thought that person that would be sanctified and would be honored to show the honor of HaKadosh Baruch Hu between me and you, one of us, they were greater than us to be sanctified for such a thing to show the honor of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Bayit of Aharon, and Aharon became quiet, was crying. When he heard that, he kept quiet and he accepted the gezeirah of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. In other words, he kept quiet, and that's life. One of the points in life is that the Malchut of Hashem is to accept Malchut of Hashem. Moshe called Mishael with Safon, the children of Uziel, the uncle of Aharon, and told them, come close and carry the brothers made by Kodesh outside the Machane. Even though that they got fire, doesn't mean that they became ashes. Now she says that the fire went to their nose and they burned the neshama, not the goof. And they came and they carried the kutotam with their tonics. We can't have a dead body over this. Your hair, you should not allow grow long. And your garments, you should not trend. Even that the over should let his hair grow and should rent, it should, it's here, it's because him, should not do it. Why? Because today is a simcha of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, should not disturb the simcha. And if you do that, then HaKadosh Baruch Hu would become wrathful over the assembly, and your brothers, they should cry for this, therefore you are not allowed to do this show in a sign of mourning, because you are bringing the korbanot and it's the yom chitva and happiness for HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And from the from the entrance of Ohel Moed Lotus Rudin Gav, 10 Tamut might die. It's like Hashem and Mishad, because the oil of Mishad Hashem Alechem, and the Richter Moshe, even that was very hard for them, they did what they were that, HaGadosh Baruch Hu said. Atabir Hashem Moed Aharon, Hashem told Aharon and more saying, in other words, wine and any type of intoxicating, you should not drink, you and your children with you, when you come to Ohel Moed, you should not die, the decree forever for Techem, will appear to separate, to distinguish between Kodesh and Chol, between contaminated and pure, will horod to teach Bnei Yisrael, it kolah hachukim, ul avdi hasher diber, Hashem alakechem b'yad Moshe. Therefore, now Barbanir says, what is the mi'chud of the parashah Yayin v'shechol al tesh? Now, the Midrash says that they were a little bit shikor. And through that, what happened, the mistake that happened was they were a little bit shikor. What does it mean, shikor, shikor? They said that we should drink a little bit to allow Tavot Shvar to loosen up. And that caused whatever that happened. Barbanir says that once we have the Shekinah and everything, Havashvarku is telling Kohanim, you should be very careful. You are in charge of the maintaining Shekhinah in Beit HaMikdash and in Mishkan. Therefore, you should be very careful. All the time, you have to be alert. You can be drunk. You can, because it's language between Kodesh and Chol, and Ulurot Ben Israel and teaching. Now, somebody wants to give Horah, he cannot drink wine. Once on a Purim, there was a question in Halacha, we had to ask the Dayan somebody, and this person says, no, I'm not capable of passing, because Torah says the horot ben Israel, somebody who's a shikor is drunk, is not allowed to pass in halacha. By that, Ben Moshe el Aharon v'Elazar v'Tamar b'ana v'Natarim, and Moshe told Elazar v'Tamar the children that they will remain to take the fire meal offering and hotel that's left from the fire offering of Hashem v'Ichluha, and you should eat matzot etzel ha-mizbeach. Next to the Mitzvah, he put Jodesh Batos Jim. Bachal te motah and should be on my Badesh. Kichoka is rule, your portion, and the portion of your children from the fire of Rehav Shem. Kichen su bete ozot, ve tachase ad nufa, and the chest of the waving, and the thigh of the was raising up. Tochlu should be akum tahor, you and your children, with you. Kichoka, because that's your portion and portion of your children. Mitzvah Shalmi Ibn Yisrael, Mitzvah Shalmi Yisrael. Shogat Teruma, the thigh of that raising up the chazeh and the chest of tenufa waving alisha upon the fire offering a chalavim yabiyu b'yomi lahafid levan the movie they should shake in front of Hashem where the levan yochav should be able to chilen it talk with you the korban portion forever kashet to Hashem. Therefore, one of the part of the korbanot is achira of kohane. It's interesting. We have two types of achira: consumption of the misbeach. We put on the misbeach would consume it in the fire. And eating of the Kohanim. And Chazal tell us, both bring kapara. Now, the kapara misbeach, it happens because the person should feel, I should have to be consumed. That had to happen to me. It's another way of getting atonement and kapara is when Kohen eats it. What does it mean? Why is it kapara? Atonement comes through eating. Eating sounds very materialistic. Why does it happen? Well, we have to understand, the eating of the Kohen is very different than the eating of a human beings. A human being that gets hungry and he eats. It's a pleasure. It's a matter of pleasure. But the Kohen that he works in Beit HaMikdash, a Kohen that works in Mishkan, he becomes like a malach. He's above Gashmud, above materialistic. And he just eats it to be Mekadeshem Shamayim. He eats it part of the Korban to show to connect the materialistic with HaKadosh Baruch Hu, social connection, that the eating is not just myself of animalistic act that the person does. Through this animalistic act, they make elevation to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That's Misbeyach. Misbeyach makes the connection between Kahal Yisrael and HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Kohanim, every Kohen is Achira, is eating. Is eating, is life, whatever that he's doing, is making connection to the materialistic life of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and that brings the greatest atonement. And that ultimately is our life. Our life has to be, any aspect of our life, a connection between us and HaKadosh Baruch Hu. We shouldn't look at the like activities of life and might say that we should go through about the eats we go through, so about the sleeps we go through. No. Every function of life is an avodah. What's the avodah? To give life, to give chiyut to the maestro of Gashmi. Person, like Rambam says, the person could eat, could sleep, could eat like an animal, and is just indulging Gashmiut, or is mechaven, that this is, should be for avodat Hashem, that they should be able to do avodah better, to be able to come closer to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Then this act and that act are different from earth to Shamayim. Better say Rachatot and Seir, the goat of the Chatot, Darush Darash, inquired Moshe, it was burned, and he got angry on Esau Tamar, and told him, Matua, why didn't you eat the Chatot Makom Kodesh? Kodesh Hashem, who Hashem gave Rachel to carry the Avon Ha'eda, they brought one Seir still of Rosh Kodesh, because it was Rosh Kodesh, and they brought. No. They ate the korbanot that was brought on that day, korbanot of Shah. And Hashem told them to eat. No, but the seer of Rosh Chodesh, Rasit Avon Aveda, they didn't eat. Moshe Rabbeinu got angry. He said, why didn't you eat at seer of Rosh Chodesh also? He says, no. But then Aaron told him, hen lohuba. Madu alu achalti mazhu otah, birata alachim Rasit Avon Aveda. Then Luvai Dama, it wasn't brought the Dama of Chodesh Benema, Chodesh Benema, Achol Tochlo, Tav Shuli, Bachodesh Hashem Tzviti. No, it wasn't brought in the Mizbeach HaSahav. The Rabbani with that was not brought in the Mizbeach HaSahav. You should eat from Chata. Hayda Ber Aharon Moshe El Hayom, Tavriv with Chata Tam, with Oro Tam, with Hashem. Today we brought Chata Tam, with Hashem. But Tirin Aoti Kaile, we became like that. We are on him. Today we are on him. Somebody died. Vachati Chata Tam, Hayta Ber Hashem, we died. Now you here, for the Urbano that has to be brought for today. But Seir of Rosh Chodesh is the Korban forever. It's a permanent Korban. Should not be eaten. Vayishma Moshe v'tabena. Moshe heard and came good in his eyes. They were very interesting. Now, Rashi says that v'tabena v'hoda v'lo bosh l'ma l'o shamati. In other words, he admitted that he was wrong. Hoda v'lo bosh l'ma Shamati, and he wasn't embarrassed to say that I didn't hear. Therefore, that is the greatest of Moshe Rabbeinu. Now, the greatest of a system is not a system that doesn't do any sin, doesn't do any wrongdoing. The greatest of a system is a system that if they do something wrong, they act. And that's in Torah. It's very interesting that this parasha, Rosh Chodesh of Nisan, starting the Mishkan, brings out the greatness of Aharon and Moshe. Moshe is the rabbi of Gahal Israel. What's the greatest of a rabbi? The greatest of a rabbi is when he finds out that he did something, a mistake, Vayishma Moshe, Vayitabena, it came good in his eyes. Because in his eyes, what's important is the truth. It's not his kavod, it's not his prestige, it's not what he stands for. He wants the truth. Whoever brings the truth to him, that makes him happy. That is what he's living for. Because in this world, we are living to find out the truth. And if we don't find out the truth in this world, we're going to hear it on next world. But next world, it is going to cost us a lot. It's much better to hear right now. Therefore, it's very interesting. The psychology of a person is, when you hear the truth, you want to deny the truth. Because on earth, the person feels earthly and like Olam Hasidic, and he wants to uplift himself. It's embarrassing for him to feel that he made a mistake. He wants to cover it up. But somebody that understands life is truth, Hashem is truth. If we don't get the truth now, we're going to get it 5 years from now, 10 years from now, 20 years from now, or in Olam Haba. And Olam Haba, hearing the truth is very painful. Because you see that you live a life of shaker of false, and you wasted, and it was waste. Therefore, when a person hears the truth, he understands the good point, true point, he has to admit, he has to be happy. Baruch Hashem, I realize that. That's the greatest of Moshe. That's the avodah of a rabbi who gives the Torah, transforms from transforming of Torah. Now, Aharon in the other way is avodah. Avodah means submitting to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Avodah means kol levavchem, full heart to do avodah. The avodah is person comes and submits himself totally to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. We give over ourselves. When we daven Shemoneh Esrei, we give over ourselves to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. We say all of the elements of life is in your hand. My chokhmah, my parnasa, my health, my judgment, my everything that I have is in your hand. Person gives over himself to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Now, when Aharon, two of his children died in the parasha of Vayitom Aharon, he accepted the Gisla of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That acceptance is the greatest mark of Avodah. Person wants to know the person could be over the HaKadosh Baruch Hu properly or not. See if you accept the Gisla of Hashem properly or not. Person cannot accept the Gisla of Hashem. It's not the over. The true Eved is the one who accepts the Gisla and the decree of Hashem. Vayitom Aharon, therefore, this parasha brings out the point of Aharon and Moshe. Aydaber Hashem el Moshe v'Aharon lemor. Hashem told Moshe v'Aharon lemor alehem, to them. No, what's alehem? Rashi says, Amar Shem alehem tamah. Now the word in this passage, Torah is telling that the HaKadosh Baruch Hu spoke to Moshe Aaron and the children, all of the family together. Dabre Mitzrayim, et kulam, Rashi, Dabre Mitzrayim, speak to Bnei Yisrael and all of you, Dabiru. Dabiru is the plural form, not you. In other words, Hashem spoke to Moshe Aaron and Mor Alehem, and Hashem spoke to Moshe Aaron and the children all together. Dabiru, she said, Bnei Yisrael, she said, Zot Hachaya Hashetochu. This is what you should eat. We could have payment from the Asher Dalwar. Now the Rashi says, Abel inside, et kulam shavil yot shiluchim betibulse. He made all of them agents to give the halacha of kashrut to give over. Usually, the halacha goes from Hashem to Moshe to Aharon. And then Moshe would say to Aharon first, and then to the children, and then to Shevet Zevachim, and then goes to Kahal Yisrael. Here, HaKadosh Baruch Hu made all of the children and Moshe equal. Moshe, Aharon, and the children equal all together became agent to give over the kashrut. Now Rashi says, why did Hashem do that? It could have shown you to become a devotee. The fish who show with the mima. Because all of them were equal in keeping quiet and accepting the gezra of HaKadosh Baruch Hu be'ahava with love. Therefore, since all of them, they kept quiet, and they accepted the decree of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That's a great tragedy. With Ahava, not only they accepted with Ahava, with love, they became the agents to give over the halacha of kashrut. Now, before Shem say, what's a shaykhut? Why? What does that have to do with the fact that all of them kept quiet? They're gonna become the ones who carry. Who becomes agent of kashrut. A lot of times, when they come and they tell us the law of kashrut, they bring out the point that why the Hashem give us kashrut? They say, no, no, this is not good, healthy, this is this. Now, what about if the science would say this is very healthy, but the science would say this is good, then what's going to happen? A lot of times, I'm very, very against these things that they come and they try to justify the things of Torah according to the science. Because what about if science would say the otherwise? Then what? Then you are telling me and we're gonna listen to science? Oh. No. In other words, HaKadosh Baruch Hu here in a very beautiful way is giving us the halacha of kashrut. It tells us, see this Aharon and the children, all of them, they accepted the decree of HaKadosh Baruch Hu with Ahava, even though they didn't understand what's the reason, why, how, but they accepted. Kashrut also is the same thing, the decree from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. We need that motivation. We need that mentality of the Aharon and the children that they accepted upon themselves the decree from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That's the way that Hashem wants it. And through that, they accept it. They should accept halacha of kashrut also. What HaKadosh Baruch Hu says over here in kashrut. Now it's very interesting that Ramban says in this parashah, we have two parashahs in kashrut, parashat Shemini, parashat Deh. In first parashah, Ramban says, you know, it's good for you, it's healthier, it's there. And parashat Deh says, it's a chuk, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, it's chuk. Unfortunately, as a satira in Ramban, one place he says that, you know, there are real rules in nature that we could understand, we could follow. And this is chuk that we don't understand. In other words, both are true. In other words, see, HaKadosh Baruch Hu created the world. Hashem knows the mechanism, what's good, what's not good. And obviously, if Hashem says, don't eat, it's not good for us. Now, the question is, do we understand or not? See, you have to understand always in life, there's the big difference between science and Torah. See, Torah tells us the knowledge from inside to outside. Because the knowledge of Torah is the knowledge of creation. Hashem created the mechanism of the Bria. He knows from the fact of the creation what is the essence of anything, everything. But the knowledge is the other way. Knowledge, they don't go inside, they took from outside and they go deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper. Imagine, I tell you a good moshe. Imagine if they say an orange has vitamin C. Let's say Zohar would say, we don't have orange here, orange is in another planet. And the Zohar HaKadosh would say that orange has vitamin C. Now we send space, we send space and the astronaut to go up to another planet and take a layer from that orange and bring it here. It takes a layer from the orange, brings it here, and we put it in lab, and we see there's no vitamin C. So there's a contradiction. The Zohar says, or the Torah says, there is vitamin C, this out of that orange. And they took a layer, and they say there's a mitzvah. There is a contradiction. But we don't understand. See, when the Zohar and Torah says there's vitamin C, because Torah knows the mechanism of the creation. He knows what is created there. Science goes from outside and takes the layers out and out and out, realizes and understands. That's why science in every 5-10 years, it's going to be the different science, different understanding, different relating to the things differently. Because they go deeper and deeper, they take layers. And through that, they find out new stuff. But Torah tells us, therefore, it's not a contradiction. Torah tells us very inner part. Maybe it takes them a long, long time to get to that layer that Torah is talking about. Therefore, Torah says over here, that was the decree. Now, we're going to go to Halakha of Kashrut. Then Rashi brings the Midrash. The Midrash says, to the Chayam, Moshe would hold each one of them, and he would show to them, to the Chayam, Rashon Chayim, it's fine. Mashal to the two sick people that they go to doctor, and they have the same sickness. One of them says that you have to special diet. The other one says that you don't have to keep any diet. You could eat whatever that you want. The one that has a special diet asks why. Says that, see, he's going to die anyway. Doesn't make difference for him. But there is a hope for you. They were keeping diet. Chayot gives you chiyut and life. So that chayot that you showed them. Now, HaKadosh Baruch Hu created the world with four elements. These four elements that HaKadosh Baruch Hu created the world, we know they are afar, dirt, dust, mayim, water, Ruach, air, and ash, fire. Now, these four elements that HaKadosh Baruch Hu created in the world are these four types of animals that we're going to learn what is kosher, what's not kosher. Therefore, you see the mechanism of the Bria that HaKadosh Baruch Hu created all four. HaKadosh Baruch Hu created Mayim, Ruach, and ash through these four elements, created everything. The halach of Kashrut goes by these four elements. And I was going to distinguish what is good, what's not good. Now let's go. Kol mafreset parsa, v'shosat shesa, prasot, ma'aradira, v'abema, utatukhele. Now first we start with the soda offer. All of the animals and wild animals are from the soda offer. Why? What does this offer mean? Everything is created from four. But this means that by these animals, this yesod is much more. That's why they are very heavy, full of meat, heaviness, and the meat. And that represents the offer, that the combination of offer in them is much more than the other things. Now, kol mafreset parsa, that has the spirit of hoof, v'shusachesa. In other words, we need the spirit of hoof, not only to be spirit of hoof by itself. If you could show this picture, if you could show this picture of art school, if you have it, or my screen, could show the picture. See, having just spirit is not enough. Just having the spirit is not enough. What should we have? We should have the you see the picture?
Which page is it on?
Art scroll?
Yeah.
676. 677. Now, if it has the hole, it's not good enough. It has the hole as Shusachesa, means spread it through a split completely, prosod into double hoops. Now, some animals, they have some type of split, but split is not all the way, it's not good. That's why it's not just mafreset parsa. First of all, you have to have hoof. If it does not have hoof, it's not kosher. Then, Shusachesa, it has to have separated hoofs, two shoes. Prostod, it should complete. Malat Gero, and it brings up and bring that is cut, but behema, Uta to Kherushudet. Akhetir to Hushudat, even Malat Gero, from the one brings Brigham is cut, Mafreshe Parso, that is hoof is split up, it Agamal, the camel, Malaki Malat Gero, it brings up his cut, Uparasa in Mafis, and the split is not is there. Tomula, Levita Shafan. Shafan also came out of the brings up his cut. Uparasol is Tom Ulachel with Arnevet and the Arnevet Hail came out of the road, brings his cut. Uparasol is not Tom Ulachim with Achazir and the pig came out of his parcel. He is the other way. Mafis parcel with Shasasha. In other words, perfect. It has the hoof and split up completely. Who Gerolu Igra and he, but it doesn't cut his shoe. Therefore, Esav is compared to the pig because he puts out his hooves and he says, look at me, I'm kosher. But the problem is inside. Tom Ulache, Mr. Amlotechel from the meat you should not eat, we know Tom Lotigau, and the carcass you should not touch, Tamil, the areas they make the tummy, etc. You should eat Mikulash Bamay. No. Offer, we finished the offer, therefore offer, we need to have hoops and Shosachesa, complete hoops and cut his he brings up his cut. Now we're gonna go to Yesod of Mai. It's the Tuchlu from that. Mikulashir Mai, but where that's body, Kulashir was Napir Begaset. All with us, fins and scales, Bamayim in the water, Bayamim in the seas, when the Khalim in the streams, Utom Tuchadu. But where that doesn't have fins and scales, Bayamim in the seas, when the Khalim in the streams, because Shir is the Mai from the creeping things in the water, Kunavish Khaya. Ashramayim Shekhet Urachim, Shekhet should be Shekhet Abunu Shekhet Uyu, Shekhet Urachim, Yisram, from the meat you shouldn't eat, when you brought them, Karkas shouldn't Shekhet Su, you should be abominate, Kurashi and Lobsha, but whatever that doesn't have fins and scales, that in the water, Shekhet Urachim, abomination for you, with Eret Shatum, very good. The water fish is fins and scales. Now, before you explain that fins and scales, that's for offer, now it's Yisram Mayim. So basically, what the combination of water is in them is a lot. And the fish, why do it fins and scales? Before she explained that, if it does have fins and scales, they are very low in the water. They don't come up, they don't see sun, they don't land, and the combination of the body is not healthy for human consumption. By bird, Torah doesn't give us any simon, which one is good, which one is not good. By bird tells us the name of the bird that do not kosher. Now, the Gemara says from here we learn out that the number of the birds that are kosher are more than the number of the birds that do not kosher. That's why Torah says the name of the bird that do not kosher. Through that you figure out that the rest are kosher. Therefore, now it was recently they found the bird. There was a question whether it's kosher or not. Now, what was the question? In other words, if you could identify all of these birds that are not kosher, then any bird, we would figure it out if it belongs to this group or not. The only problem is we cannot identify these birds completely. We don't know exactly what they are. Therefore, maybe one bird comes. Therefore, what do? We eat what we have Yom Mesorah. What do we have tradition that's kosher we eat? That's not kosher, we don't eat. Now, even though the Chachamim in the Mishnah in Chulin, Chachamim gave a simon for the bird, that simon is for Chachamim. But Torah itself doesn't give any simon, it just says the name. Therefore, Shechles Rachim, Abu Neshe for you, Etaneshe, Neshe, Eagle, Veta Piras, Veta Osnia, Veta Ta'a, Veta Ayal, Lemino, that called Aro, Rev Lemino, or of the Orev, Orev is Club, Lemino, this one. That's why art school doesn't translate them because we don't know some of them what's the right translation. Betachos, betasholach, betayanshuf, betadisham, betafav, betarucham, betachasida, nafal emina, betadufa, betadup. Chasida, chasida. Why is it called chasida? So daya levana, damalira chasida. She was a chasid in chabrutah b'mezudah. She said he does chasidut. He does kindness to his own type. And gives mesonot. Now, before Shem say, if that's the case, why don't we eat it? If it does chesed, therefore should be good. Why don't we eat it? We don't eat it because of doing chesed to his own kind. In other words, somebody is real bal chesed. That's chesed to everybody. But somebody that's just chesed to himself and to his own kind is the ultimate being selfish and self-centered. Because that's chesed to them, because he sees them part of himself. But real chesed is a person should go above and beyond and to do chesed. With the kol sheret of all of the creeping of ha'olech that goes on the four legs, sheret u'lachim, I'm going to share for you. Only this, because sheret of all of the creeping of ha'olech alaba that goes, walks on the legs, on four legs, asher lo kiraim, and he has a jumping legs. From extending above his legs, the natel point that he, to spring about with them on the earth. They were that talking about especially grasshopper that you know Timonim they have the mesora and they eat it. Et elemem tochlun ata arbe lemino arbe betaslayim leminehu betargol leminehu betargol leminehu. Bechoshir esav all of the creeping of the belt ashelu arba that has four legs. Shekat sulachem amchavet leitamu chavetamu kol agiam elvatam. If you touch the nivlatam, it's going to be a tarif. If somebody carries the nivla, the dead body, you have to wash the god of the tarif. The whole habema, all of the bema, as you know, is a parsa that has splitted hoofs, which is in an ashosa, but it's not, it doesn't separate. We get out in our malib, somebody touch him with the tarif. So if you have a little kapab, where it goes on its palm, that goes on four. Tupor talks about Israel eating, now talks about that they become Tommy Bahnosia. And somebody who carries the dead bodies should wash his garment with Tommy Adari with Tamim and Rachim. There are two points here. One point is Tommy to eat, but the point is the dead body is Metame. Now we're going to go to Yesod of, therefore, Bird or Avir. Now we're going to go to Yesod of Esh. That is creeping Shadaris, Hakole, the Akhabar, Batarim. There's Shimona Shiratim here, that one of the program of Shabbat, Master Shabbat, that's going to learn the Fiomi is Shimona Shiratim, that talks about these eight Shiratim. Hakole, Akhbar, Mais, Vahatsav, the Minehu, and Tsav, Hanaka, Bakov, Arata, Bakov, and Shamit, Edatim Lachim, Jabbaris. When they die, they become tummy adults. When they are alive, they don't become tummy. They don't become tummy. They don't become tummy. Because actually, for Allah, mehim memutam, and whatever that falls on the memutam, it one because kaliyat from any wood vessels or baggage, cloth or ore or leather or sock or sacks, called kaliyat actually yasim racha. All of the utensils that you do racha with them, be mine yuva, be mine. Into the water shall it be brought the tummy and it should be condemned at Adairev till night the time becomes now. The Torah says, the Torah, this eight Shemrashim, one of the Shiratim lives in the tunnel with the fire. Therefore, that's why these Shiratim are the Yisud of fire. In other words, as we said, there are two elements combining the combination of fire in them, this Shemrashim, and they are metame and they make tam. Now we're going to learn about the Hikot of Tuma. Kol keli cheres, ashe pol mehem, el tochot. Now, we have the vessel of earthenware, earthen vessels that people may eretocho. If the shares falls inside kurashe betocho itma, whatever that's inside becomes tameh betodishbar and should break it. Because for kelicheres there is no way that the tumah could come out. We cannot go to mikveh. The ramiyeh binar kelicheres as a no. Ramiyeh binar kelicheres becomes tameh from inside, not from outside. In other words, a metal keli or wooden keli, even if the tummy touches outside, becomes tummy. But cheres doesn't become tummy only from inside. Now, Mepharshim say why? Why keli cheres becomes tummy only inside and wooden and the metal even from outside? Because see, the tumor is not what we think. In other words, contamination like a contagious disease. Tumor is a spiritual matter. This is spiritual matter. Falls the way that HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants. Now, what makes something tummy is a function of that thing. Now, keli cheres is the earthen word, don't have chashivu. The material is not chashu, it's not important. What's chashu? The fact that's a function like a keli, that contains, we could put inside. Therefore, that the fact that contains, that in itself is the function of the keli. Therefore, through that function, the tumah comes through containing. We call it from all of the food that could be eaten, asher yavu ala mayim, that the water comes over it, itma. In other words, the food, as long as water doesn't come on it, it's not tummy. Once you have to pick it from the tree, then it has to be water over it, then becomes tummy. We call mashka asher ishtate, all of the drink that becomes tummy, we call keli, itma. Therefore, Torah is saying the parasha of tumah here. First of all, we learn that the utensils become tummy, the food becomes tummy, the drink becomes tummy. From all of the whatever that falls from how does it become tummy? With the dead bodies, Allah, itma, tanur vikirayim. If you have an oven vikirayim, toss, shall be smashed, temeim. Therefore, this tanur and kirayim that talk about the oven and stove is not connected to floor, not ground. If it's connected to the ground, the bite doesn't become tummy. Whatever that's connected to ground doesn't become tummy. The tannery camp that could be moved, that then if it becomes tummy, then since it's the earthen world, there is no way to get it back, to make it tahor, purify it. What should we do? The only way that becomes, we have to break it. Ach mayon ubor mirve mayim ye tahor, regem la tam itpa. Ach mayon, only. Only Torah is saying that Hamukwalim Lekarka in Megabin to Achmayon, the Nadu spring, Upur, a cistern, Mirwe, gathering of water that's Mihuba, that's connected to the ground, Tahor. Even if Sheres falls on it, it doesn't become Tami. Somebody says the Mayon, another spring of water that there is a Sheres Tami inside, becomes Tami. No, it doesn't. Because since it's Mihuba Lekarka, it doesn't become Tami. Mikve mayim, a gathering of water that's mechubar to galka, it doesn't become tame. Vodesh nemot jitor hatu elbaim tmato venugi abin vatam itma. And somebody becomes an utor. We could learn that somebody now. Therefore, Torah is saying two things: mayon bor mikve mayim yitor beva tahor. And if the sheres falls on it, it doesn't become tame. And tahor, somebody who is tame, if he goes to the mayon or goes to the bor or mikve mayim, becomes tahor. Vechi for milvatam. When it falls from their dead bodies, I'll call Zera Zerua on the seed that was the Zera seed that is a food, Ashi Zera that has been planted, Tahuru, it's Tahur. If the nebula falls on the food, still the food is Tahur. Why? Because we need the prerequisite for that become Tahur. Bechutan Maim al Zera, when it was had been placed, water on the Zera on the seed. Therefore, we said that to food become tummy first, we have to have water on them. If we don't have water on them first, it doesn't become tummy. They will have to put water on them. Then, if after becoming in contact with water, the nevela, the tummy falls on that, becomes tummy. In other words, now Torah tells us the kosher animals that we eat. That also becomes tame if they died. Somebody touches becomes tame. If you shecht it and you eat it, of course, that tame is good. But if the kosher animal dies, becomes tame. Somebody eats the nebela. Now they were from the dead body that wasn't shecht. The chavis becomes tame. He has to wash them. بنوسته اتام بود که از نبلای خبس بودا با تام ادارف بخور اشیرس کریپین الارز شقس شود نات بیتن کل اول گوز اون دی گاخون بیبی بخور اول اون گوز اون دی فور البر برگیم وی دی نیومرس لگز کل اشیرس اشورس الارز اون کریپین اون دی ارث لو تخلوم شود نات بیتن شود نات بیتن کی شیرس املاخیم شیرس املاخیم از چه اگر سورم شد تخیم شود نات اپومینیت یور سول with all of the creeping things, and you should not contaminate them. Ritmetem bam, and should become contaminated them. Ritmetem bam is without olive. Now Rashi says, ritmetem bam, im atem metamim ba'in beres, afani metam etchem be'olam haba, v'shuah shel ma'ala. If somebody becomes tamme with them, I make you tamme also mil ma'ala. Ritmetem without olive, ritmetem means metamet heart. It locks up our heart. I'm Hashem, your God. We should sanctify yourself with the Gadushim, Gadushani, Gadush, Blue Tamu should not be Tamu your soul, because Hashem is Aramis Aris, keeping Aramis Aris. I'm ashamed that I brought you up from Israel to be God for you, with him Gadushim, Gadushani. So, this is the laws of the Behemoth of the Oak, before Nevesh Haya, all of the living creatures, Aramis creeping by Mayim, before Nevesh Hacheresed, and the creatures of the creeping Aris. They have deal to separate Ben Tom with Haor, Ben Achaya, and Achelet, Ben Achaya, being the creatures that would be eaten, you stand up without eating. They were here. Torah tells us that all of these things, the Torah tells us that, therefore, basically, we talk about the law of Kashrut.